Hello, YouTube. I just thought I would show you a video sharpening my new Bloom knives from Steel of Bloom. The maker is Ørjan Bloom. It's 15 and 20. I'm gonna sharpen this little all-purpose knife, a Bunka and a Sujiki. I'm just gonna start Nanniwa Professional 1000, then Aotoshi, then 5000. I'm just gonna wet my thousand. Just wetting a little here to make sure they stick together. Here. And drawing to make sure it's flat. Just the pencil. They are sharp, but I like to put a new edge on everything. I got it. It can be a little sharp. I'm just gonna check. Yep, that's in here. I can do this. I'm just gonna fill up this. There it's flat. There, that's full of water. Just put something soft on my phone. No diamond plate for it. Sponge, I use that after cutting, but I don't like it full of soap, so I'm just gonna get the soap out of it. There, wiping my hands a little. So I said it was 15 and 20, I don't know the heat rate. I'm guessing about 61, 62 ish. I'm hoping they will keep an edge just a good time, but it's basically 1075 with lots of nickel. So yeah, I'm gonna go pretty low. This is flat. I'm just gonna go maybe a degree or two over completely flat. This is a pretty tough steel, so I'm reckoning it will hold it, so. See. I'm starting a new bevel here. Can you see that, how high it is? These are pretty thin knives. From the maker. He said he could take them thinner, but yeah, these are what he does for a reasonable knife. So I'm gonna exchange two of my knives. For these knives, my Takamura in R2 SG2 and my Eden Kanso in Aogami 2. Around, and I'm sure it's up there. Actually, got a tiny burr, so keep going a little at the heel. These are pretty and non-wear resistant knives, so easy to sharpen, easy to maintain. I'll put a devilishly low acute edge, as good as a zero grind, on this, because it's all purpose knife, you don't need a sturdy edge on this. They're a little at the tiny belly. And the knives, they are so damn light, you can't feel them picking them up. So they seem good quality, but I don't know for sure after seeing what they can get me. A little more just here. There. And imagine this is flat, I'm sharpening there, just so the spine here doesn't rub against the knife. So maybe 2-3-4 degrees tops is what I'm sharpening at. And people are saying that's way too low. No, it isn't. We're cutting food here, not rope. Not cardboard, not wood, etc. You can go as low as that if you're careful. This isn't gonna hit the cutting board much. It's gonna do in-hand cutting, like peeling, etc. So it will have no problem with that. Oh, sorry about that. Drinking some Swedish beer, Pripps Blå. It's a wheat beer, only 2.8, but it tastes good. It's very cheap, 4 kroners a can. 5-6 kroners maybe, as we see. It's 24 for 6 of them, so... tastes good. I'm not drinking to get drunk, I'm drinking because it tastes damn good. Nothing tastes better than ice cold beer in this heat. It's so damn warm in Norway, it's like, yeah, it's like being down south. Here I got my burr. I'm just gonna go a little bit lower. As I saw, the scratch marks wasn't even, and these are mono steel, just one steel, so it don't matter if you sharpen 50-50, but I'm gonna try as good as I can. They feel great on the stones. I don't know if that's the nickel or. Let's see. Just a little. Throw at the heel here. Here. Little up at the tip. And now I'm creating just a shinogi line. Or blade pot. Here, just a little more behind the edge. I'm hoping you can see this. I can see it clear as day, but... can you see the scratch pattern here? Looking pretty uniform. So, I'm gonna do that on both sides, and of course creating a burr, but also tinning. And some crap on my stone. Ah, shit, that moved the blade bit up a little. Just a tiny piece of dirt on the stove, but yeah, you don't need to be perfect. There, that looks good. It's razor thin. I got a burr on both sides. Oh, that was stuck good. Sorry about that. Moving to my sorry, Naniwa Toshi. You know, I seem drunk, but I ain't. I'm just a little slow in the heat. It's 30-35 Celsius every day nearly in Norway now, so it's too warm to function like a human being. Let's see, I think I need to pick it up. And there, it's flat. I'm just gonna, maybe I can sheet a little. Putting down one of these napkins. And using as underlay for my stone. Just come around the corners. My Atoma, just rinsing it off good, so wiping my hands, and I'm gonna continue seeing how low I can make the edge. How low can you go? It is a beautiful little knife. Would love just a little pocket knife like this. Beautiful little EDC everyday carry knife. There, just checking that there aren't any hard particles on the stone. Yep. There was something sticking. Now, using just the weight of the blade, polishing it up. And these knives are gonna outperform my Shibata Kotetsu in cutting when I'm done with them. The edge retention will be far from it, but the poor cutting, it will match. Damn, that polish is quick. Holy crap. Sorry about my language, but that's impressive. It's... yeah. Just gonna polish the side of the blade, aiding in both corrosion resistance but also thinning it out. Actually got a burr there. Can't believe it, but yeah, I can show you how quick it polishes. Look at that. Holy hell, that's a mirror finish nearly. I'm stunned. I'm just gonna keep, since the stone has clogged, it cuts just less and less. I'm just gonna put some pressure on it now and polish it up. Just flip the zone, so. I'm gonna go up and touch the very edge. Pretty damn good. Just removing the build up so it pops again. And that's all about what it took. Swig of fair. I'm going to do this with this knife. Then the Bunkan Tsujiki too. I'm just gonna let the mud aid it a little. Just adding a few drops here and there so it won't dry out too much. Didn't know this stone was that good as a polisher. I don't like it to the very edge because the edge gouges the stone extremely easily, but the polish is damn good. This would be good for polishing a Yanagiba, I think. Good, actually. I don't feel like I own a knife before I put it to the stones. That's when I make it mine. I know it's weird, but yeah. Could never own a knife that someone else sharpened for me. I must sharpen it myself to become a part of the knife. It's pretty good. They're moving up to the very edge. Yes, using the white. Oh shit, I gouged the stone. Nearly cut myself. It's so soft, this stone. So I'm working with those thin edges, yeah. Just gonna check how it cuts off this stone before moving to my much harder 5000. Just wiping so the paper, it's already wet, but yeah, I won't make it any wetter. Just dropping the little blade a little on the cloth I used to drive it. There. Checking, this is in view. It's pretty damn sharp already, but as always, pretty damn sharp isn't scary holy shit sharp. So we're taking it to the next level. Next level is my 5000 that has started to develop some micro cracking. This I know is flat, but I'm just gonna take off a good bit of material so it, the cracks don't start developing. This is gonna be one scary sharp knife when I'm done with it. Because the angle is gonna be... I'm gonna make it zero. It's zero ground now. Let me see. Yeah, I can't see a protruding bevel or so. There. Just starting some mud, and this don't clog it. Oh, which I love. So I can use quite a bit of pressure. It's gone. So see, it cuts beautiful. Now I'm zero grounding it. I'm putting it spine. Just doing
maybe that amount.
Just maybe half a millimeter from the spine touching the stone. That looks very promising. And soon feel the burr, and this is such a soft, or not soft, it's around 61, I'm guessing 61, 62, it feels like that, so but it polishes up so damn nice. I'm thinking, is it one of the corners I'm looking there. I think that helped. Now I think maybe a half a degree from flat wheat edge. Actually feel the burr there or something. The same thing here, polishing up the sides. There. As you see, I'm trying to utilize the full motion of the stone. don't know if this crack, it feels like I'm hitting something. There's nothing on the stone that I can feel with my hands, but I feel it very good with the blade, so. Let's see. Tinningling. Side of the blade, as I said. Just going barely the weight of the knife. So we hit the very edge. I'm just gonna try to clean it a little with a finer stone to see if it's that keep pulsing it. Maybe some deeper scratches. Sorry about this taking long, but I want to get it perfect when I first do it, so. Actually feel the burr of the backside. Something off with this stone, or yeah, something weird. Making sure it's got no burr by cutting into a pencil very, very lightly. And the shit that is sharp, I can feel it on the pencil, so. I think that will do it. Just wiping it off, drawing. cat's leg. Just to get rid of any tiny, tiny burr. Surely looks great. It's a little coarser up at the belly. I'm just gonna do some quick stropping there. I want this edge to be as good as I can get it off a 5000 stone. You see, here it feels good. Just wiping it a little on my dance leg. Feels pretty damn good. Checking. That's pretty sharp. That was one life. Just cutting him off a little. It was maybe a little too much. There. And now it's the bunka time. This is etched, as you see. On here too, I'm gonna go very, very low. Is a little above etching, as you see here. You see, so this is gonna look really good afterwards. utilizing all the stone. They feel great on the stone, so I hope they will be good knives. They seem like it, but you can never know. Something can have gone wrong with the heat treater.
You never know before I've tested them for long. You can see this, but I'm just starting to gnaw away at the etchings. Raising that angle. No, lowering it, sorry. Quite a bit.
You have no idea.
No, Ariana's put pretty steep microbevel on this, so I need to get that out.
I'm sharpening as close to a zero ground as I can get them, so that is a burr, either that or the edge is curved, but I'm gonna go to the backside a little. Just so I don't bend and stress the knife. As you see, I'm... Oh, that's flat, that's where I'm sharpening it at, so... Just behind the edge. I'm rocking just a tiny, tiny bit to make it a tiny, tiny bit flex. I don't want a completely flat knife. It will be near it, but it doesn't need to be it. Take off a little more in the midsection of the blade. This is the hardest thing to do as a sharpener, knife sharpener, is to thin your blades and optimize the performance. It's the hardest part of sharpening. Anyone can sharpen just the edge and get a decent result. I mean anyone, I can teach you that in 20-30 minutes.
to get a decent enough edge to cut food with. But to thin a blade, take years of experience to do right. To look at the scratches, see where you are removing metal, etc. It's so damn warm, the sweat running down my back doing this. Even more way. Yeah. It's hard work to do this in this heat. But the end result will be worth it. Fit a little there. As you see, the back side has started to brighten up. So as this side, let's see, that looks about pretty even. Moving now to create the edge from this to thinning there and a couple degree over that again. That's in. It's gonna be a long video, but yeah. I'm doing knives, I like to do them right. I like to remove quite a good bit of steel from the sides of the knives and profile it so it matches up and makes a good cutting edge. The sink bridge or something, Shepton Pond, or yeah, can't afford it. This works, but it's a pain in the butt. More up here, needed. There, flipping. Same on the other side. I'm just gonna remove the carpet so I won't get any spills on it. As you see, it's dirty work.
It's a sharpener, but it's fun.
It's fun to see your knives get better. I'm sharpening maybe 5 or 7 degrees. As I said, this feels extremely good on the stones. I hope it got good edge retention because I'm liking this blade, but 15 and 20, yeah. Edge retention, I know. If Örjan hasn't done any magic, it's gonna be pretty bad. Even better than white steel. Because it hasn't got anything to help it. Just a little more. More. There we go to it. I'm gonna lighten the pressure just to refine it a little bit. And to blend it in a little. Gonna knock off the shoulders. Toshi. Just there, cleaning it up.
Minutes.
This is gonna be over an hour, but yeah, I don't care. It's fun.
Now behind the edge again, just shining it up a little, getting that mud created.
Since I'm sharpening so thin, I got my finger.
Crap. I got it good too.
As you see.
But yeah, shit about that. The blood that makes the blade even more mine. I slipped and did this. Because it sucks into the stone when you're doing this. I'm actually using quite a lot of pressure here. Blood is dripping, but yeah. Blood and sharpening go hand in hand. This is what you do. Pay the ticket in blood.
I have enough blood, but I don't have enough knives.
Yeah, that looks good. I'm gonna hit the back side now. At least now the knife is sharp, because it cuts me, and yeah, it's bleeding. It was nearly a new cut, so. And pictures are gonna be on my Facebook. Glenn Halvor Åsheim with two A's if you want to friend me, etc. So. See. Good, I'm not bothering with all the scratches. I'm just taking off some from this side too. Now I think I'm ready to try and take the edge. Just very lightly removing some of the impurities in the stone. There. Now. Just letting it skate its own weight. Sorry about that. I got
the tripod leg is right here where I'm standing. So we're on a tripod now.
I only got my mobile phone to film it, so we'll have a better setup. Like Perfection, for example, has a perfect filming setup. Would love something like that, but my wallet is pretty stretched thin, as I'm on welfare without a job, so the economy is pretty bad. Again, polishing up the sides. Just getting it a little refined. I don't care about getting a true mirror, but just getting the worst off. Also helps a little with corrosion resistance on this carbon steel. As you see, I'm by far stretched any professional sharpener. Just amateur sharpener that loves to sharpen and getting knives as sharp as I can. Bleeding has stopped. That's the fine thing about cutting yourself with a damn sharp knife. It's such a fine wound, it's like a scalpel, so it nearly closes on itself. And I'm using quite a bit of force here. I would say 5-6 kilos, 10-12 pounds. When thinning and polishing the sides, that is. When doing the edge, I'm at 20 to 50 grams lighter than the blade. For this blade is actually so lightweight, I think I'm going with the weight of the blade. But yeah, you understand. Very, very little pressure when doing the edge. Damn good, actually. Now, again, as I said, just the weight of the knife. Just making sure there's nothing on the stone. Off there. dropping the burr once more. Again, cutting the burr off. To make sure the burr is standing completely straight, and if there is some air, actually can't see any burr stepping to the pencil, so
yep,
I can't see anything.
So
1 hour. Stopping at maybe 15. Just to create a tiny micro bevel, tinier than a hair's width. Let's just add a tiny amount of strength. Dropping a little on the sponge. Here, wiping it completely clean. Seems a little more rust resistant than white steel. I'd say on par and rust resistance with maybe a gummy tooth. Seems like that. Pants leg, it's completely dry since the cloth is a little damp. Soaping the edge just a tiny bit in case there is a little burr there. And welcome. Damn, that came out gorgeous.
I hope you can see that shine in that. That's pretty lovely there.
It's not mirror, but yeah, it's pretty good.
Here I got some paper.
It's pretty damn sharp. So, last knife. Hope you will watch all video.
this Suzuki.
Pretty beautiful knife. It's so lightweight. It's, yeah, I can't believe it. Oops.
Where's the weight at? Again, same procedure. Starting pretty thin, thinning it out. Making a razor blade, that's what I'm making. And then afterwards, I'm moving just half a degree, half a degree until I get the edge. This got some damn point on it. It's a little bent or mishammered. So, yeah, here. But it's pointy, as points can be. I think if my 5000 and a professional is breaking, I think I'm gonna try the Shapton Pro to substitute it with maybe an 8000 instead or something. It's very hard to get my fingers up on this point. I'm doing very near, completely flat. So I'm near full flat grind, chisel grind on each side. There's a tiny bit of Comex. This is a meat slicer. So this is gonna be one scary edge. Where you place your fingers as all to say when thinning in pressure and yeah. Watch John Broida over at Japanese Knife Import on YouTube. He's a hell. I mean, if I 1 from 10, I am at 1, it's level 10 at sharpening. He's a sharpening god compared to me. So watch his videos to see and improve. I want that tip to be razor thin to aid with cutting silver skin and stuff and trimming meat. That looks very good. Backside. I'm sorry if this is taking maybe a 1.5 hour, but yeah, please watch the entire thing. You're gonna see what I do, what I don't do. I don't like to edit out anything. If I make a mistake, you're gonna see him. Like when I took the little knife and gouged the stone. Because I want you to know I'm not perfect. Nor am I ever gonna be. Everybody can learn, everything can improve. The only man I think is, yeah, 99% a perfect sharpener is John Broida. You can never be 100%, but he's as close as anyone I know of. And Shibata Takayuki, of course. But he's Japanese. In the Western world, John Broida is the closest I can think of.
Mary Carter, yeah, but you can't compare Candle to John Broida. I'm sorry. I don't care what people say. I don't like Mary Carter. There's a lot of misinformation out there, in my eyes. And, yeah. Lightening up the pressure a little bit. Just ease off the scratch pattern. People say, how thin do you go? Well, I can feel it. I can feel when the edge begins to flex a little on the stone. You can feel how the knife reacts. You know, it's weird. But it's like a sixth sense.
You look. I'll thin it up here, and then at the tip I'm going full face. Same here up to here. At the tip I'm going completely. That's
thin. Yeah.
Oh, it's warm. Now creating an edge.
As said in many of my videos, please subscribe. Please, I mean it, that helps a lot. If you press like, that would say thumbs up. Leave a comment. If you got any questions, please share my videos. If my channel grows to just say 500,000 subscribers, that's just if any one of you get one, two friends to subscribe, two friends from each of you, I'm at 600. Then I can hear with sharpening sights of getting sponsored, getting free knives, free stones to test out, so I can give you more to watch. Nearly there already, so it's pretty impressive. It takes a long time to thin out a match. I can start at the 400, but yeah, I'll take my time and do it on the 1000. Here. I'm doing this right when first doing it, because why not? Why not spend extra time on doing it so you know it's perfect? This touches meat, it's just gonna go through it like silk. just missed here, but here, and there, but not there. So I'm just gonna join the edge a little more. There. And sharpening as low as this and doing what I do, make sure your flats are your stones are flat, so you don't thin and get a curve. If it's stone or like this off, you can see it with your eyes, but you will feel it in your blade. And again, as I said, the blade feels lovely on the stone. Feels like a good carbon steel. I just, yeah, it could be go from 0.75 to about 0.90 in carbon. That would be good. And maybe just say a 0.5% of chromium. Let me burn now. Just gonna knock off the shoulders. As I said, pop it up to 0.90. The carbon from 0.75, maybe just add 0.5% of chromium. Maybe 0.25 of vanadium and a little tungsten or something to give it a little more edge holding. That would be my only complaint, is the edge holding. Now lightening up the pressure just to make the burr a little smaller. Since this is the last knife, I'm gonna flatten it. I'm guessing it won't take much. As is, and now I've seen, I've sharpened quite a bit on this 1000. That's all about what it took. Yeah, it's just a tiny amount more. And there it's flat. Just taking off a little more so I don't get any cracks. Still filming. 20. Washing with polishing up the blade face. the thing, as I said earlier, maybe 10-12 pounds of horse. That's about 5-6 kilos for us with the metric system. That's hazy, but yeah. I don't really care if it's hazy or completely mirror. It just cuts like a damn demon, I'm happy. Good. Here I'm also gonna do something like that, just to make sure the needle is very pointy. No, sorry, the point is very needle-like. Yeah, that's scary. Again, we're moving just logging. I know it's flat, so I don't need to check with the pencil, because when every clog gets removed, it needs to be flat. So
I got 122. I think this will come in at 130. I'm guessing.
That's beautiful, at least in my eyes. There, drank half a liter of beer. Moving to just the very edge. This stone actually cuts very quick. It's a rich stone, so I got actually quite a big burn here. A little too big, so I need to ease up a little. It's clean.
Yeah,
130 seems about it. Polishing up the sides. Just hope the steel will be good, the edge retention, because these are excellently crafted knives, they're thin and good, so just hope the edge retention will be so I can use them a lot, because these three knives are gonna be my new favorite knives, without a shadow of a doubt. There. Moving to the very edge. Here,
128,
yeah. Looking off if they are any better. Looping. There, just dropping and washing a little on the sponge. wiping off the blade. Well, I think it's pretty good to be carbon steel, that it haven't taken a patina or rust or anything while I sharpened it, so it's at least better in white steel in rust corrosion.
See that? You can see my reflection in that.
Just as earlier, making sure it's completely dry on the pant leg. And stropping it just carefully. There.
Paper. That's no resistance at all. Tip is scary. Yep, that's all I got. Three knives, each took about half hour. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment, share the video, please. As always, Knife Sharpening Norway. Bye.